Coming to you from Oscars in downtown Palm Springs, it's the Mark and Tony Show. Today's guests are U.S. World War II veteran George Shampa and entrepreneur and vocalist Frankie Mamone, accompanied by pianist Chris Bennett. Here they are, Mark and Tony.
Wait a minute. We lost Laura Hagen. Where's Laura Hagen?
What happened to her?
Laura Hagen's right here.
Whoa.
Look at this crowd. What a crowd.
Miss Hagen, you look fantastic.
Hey, grew my hair out for you, everything.
I was going to say, it's a different kind of look that you're bringing tonight, but let the audience know tonight we're on the eve of Halloween coming up, so everybody enjoy yourself, enjoy the costumes of everybody here, including Laura Hagen. So,
Do I really need
a microphone? I just stand here and watch.
All right. Okay. So the show is yours, Tony. Go ahead. Say something.
Hold on a second. We gotta do the intro. Lu Chow.
We're not at Lu Chow.
Oh, geez, that's right.
That's right.
Oscars.
We're at Oscars. Yeah. Oscars. Yeah. Do a little Elvis.
Okay. So anyway, that aside.
Elvis was here.
No.
Elvis is now in the house. He's Italian. His name is Tony Pomponio.
Okay. With all that being said, thank you for the applause for him.
Yeah. Wait.
All right, go ahead.
Last week, when we shot the show last week, you looked like you had your pajamas on. Tonight, you look like you're going to a prom. What the hell's going on over here?
We're at Oscars. That's right. We're at Oscars.
An answer from the audience.
And, I just wanted to look sharp tonight. Last week we had the Dreamboat, so, it was just kind of laid back.
You know what happens? We had these nice looking young guys in the band, right? So this guy thinks he's going to join the band.
You're not fooling me, okay?
I know the way you roll, okay? You want to be part of the band, you're going to play the drums, you're going to do this,
I think you look fabulous.
Thank you, Laura. I really appreciate it. Oh, Laura, I keep
dying. You keep.
There we go. I keep losing it here.
Thank goodness he has no mic. Welcome, folks, to the Tony Show.
Okay.
How about that, huh? Well, it's about time.
I finally figured it out. You and Laura just decided to sabotage my microphone. Okay, fine.
Anyway,
I want to thank everybody for coming out this evening to the Mark and Tony Show, the official greeting.
Yes.
We want to thank everybody for coming out. Our weather now is fantastic here in the Valley, hence why everybody comes out to enjoy the gorgeous weather of the desert.
Yes, sir. And check out all these Halloween costumes out here. Wow.
As a matter of fact, who are you dressed up as tonight, by the way?
I'm the Elvis guy now.
He's Elvis.
Okay? And when my wife came, like somebody has a broken arm, by the way. I mean, she's got the best costume of the night, I think, don't you think?
No argument.
It's just her pinky finger.
No argument for me. But listen, we have a couple of great guests coming up this evening. I have the honor, after this break, to introduce George Shampa.
Oh, yes.
A World War II veteran that has a lot of tales of what took place back in the day and what he's been up to now. A very interesting individual. And Tony, who else is on the show?
We've got Frankie Mamone. There he is.
Front and center.
And
who will be playing the keyboard for him?
Chris.
Chris Bennett.
Yes.
There she is, the beautiful blonde. Stand up, Chris. Stand up.
I was looking for you.
There she is. So everybody, as Tony and I always sign off going into break, we'll be right back.
That's Joey DeFonso, a.k.a. Mark Murphy.
I'm no snitch, but I really don't like the way he treats women.
What do you think you're doing?
He got in some trouble with the boys back in Chicago a few months back. So the FBI bought him and his family a one-way ticket to Palm Springs, California.
I got this idea. I want to run for mayor.
On the condition that he keeps his nose clean and his mouth shut.
I don't think this is a good idea.
Yeah, like that's gonna happen.
Filmed on location in Palm Springs.
Kimball's Unique Boutique, located in beautiful downtown Palm Springs, is for women who are not afraid to attract attention. Our clothing is feminine, flirty, fun, and fabulous. Get the latest look. Large selection of jewelry, hats, and much more. Personalized service inspires our customers to keep coming back. Kimball's Boutique, across from the Hyde in beautiful Palm Springs. We look forward to having you shop with us, and don't forget to mention the Mark and Tony Show for your 20% discount on your purchase.
Hi, I'm Mark Lantera.
And I'm Tony Pomponio. Tune in every Thursday at 1 o'clock on Spectrum Fox 11 or Channel 33 on the Dish and DirecTV Network.
Music, comedy, interesting interviews every week on the Mark and Tony Show. Be there!
Welcome back, everybody, to the Mark and Tony Show. As I said, going into break with a teaser, we have a young gentleman up here sitting down to my left and Tony's left. George, welcome to the Mark and Tony Show. We appreciate it. Let the audience know a little bit about your past, what took place, how you evolved into what's going on today. I know you got a lot of history to talk about.
This is a book that I wrote my memoirs a couple of years after I got out of the Army. Back in 1950 is when I wrote the book. I got out of the Army in 46. But anyway, I have other things in the book besides my memoirs, reflections of how I think about things now. Because one of the things I've been asked a lot is, why didn't I get PTSD for what I did in the service? So let me tell you about that, okay?
Go right ahead, George.
Okay, you know my name, George Ciampa. It's really pronounced Ciampa. But anyway, when I was 18 years old, I got drafted. I tried to get in the Air Corps, my eyes weren't good enough. And so I got drafted. By the way, my eyes were good enough about 6 months later because they lowered the eye requirements for pilots to 20/30. Nobody knows that except me. And my eyes were 20/22. My company commander wouldn't let me go, so I was a replacement in a company called the 607th Graves Registration Company. Now, I'm sure that most of you don't know what Graves Registration is. When they told me I was going to be in Graves Registration, do I need to look at you guys or them?
You look right at the audience.
Okay. Actually, the camera right there.
Anyway, that camera.
I thought it was going to be a white-collar job. Well, it turned out to be gathering the dead every day for 11 months. From D-Day till the end of the war, May 8th, 1945, our job, 124 enlisted men and officers, and of course, the 124 didn't do the work, about 16 of us did. And I want to tell you one quick thing. Before I ever landed in Normandy, which I did at age 18, 112 pounds, our first platoon was selected to go on a maneuver. It's called Exercise Tiger. Now you folks ought to take a look at that on the web, Exercise Tiger, because 800 men were killed in a flash just before the invasion as they were practicing for a landing on the beach of Slapton Sands, England. Now, my platoon, there were four platoons in headquarters, was not selected to be in that exercise. But the first platoon was, and we lost 18 of our guys, six survivors, on a ship that was offshore, getting ready to practice landing on the beach. This exercise was a huge secret for many years. Initially, because they were trying to find the officers that had the maps on them where we'd actually land, what day and where. But anyway, that started us off on a bad note. You know, we said, this is no exercise. No, this is the real thing that we're on. So of course, we were scared to death and when we lost 18 of our comrades. So anyway, from the day, as I said, until the end of the war, we were in five campaigns in France, Belgium, and Germany. We initiated 17 temporary cemeteries. Now, temporary cemeteries are where they have holes dug for the bodies that are just buried in mattress covers. In fact, let me talk about the landing first. The landing, I was scared to death. Anyone that says they weren't scared to death is a liar or crazy because there was artillery firing at all the ships out there. There were ships getting sunk. There were bodies in the water, debris in the water. We were standing on a ship waiting to get off the rope ladders. We never practiced to get on a rope ladder. Some of the guys that got on a rope ladder fell in the water with all their gear and drowned. We went in on a LCI, which is a smaller landing craft. And we made three attempts to go in. And I thought they kept turning around because we could hear the 88 artillery shooting over us. You know, they used to scream. We call them screaming memes. And so that wasn't the case, though. The case was the guy driving that landing craft was looking for a place to land where there were no, I can't think of the word, but the Germans had this mechanical stuff in the water with mines strapped to them. And if you went in there and you touched one of those things, you got to blow up. So they're looking for a place to land where we wouldn't have to wade in the water. I happened to be sitting in a Jeep, and that's all I remember. You know, I told my wife, I don't remember landing. And she says, well, don't even think about it, because it'll bring back bad memories. Well, I had a lot of bad memories without thinking about it. And what I want to tell you one thing here, because I can't be on here for long. I want to tell you that what I think about now, because I've done a lot of interviews. In fact, you can see a long interview of me on YouTube that American Veterans Center put on there when they interviewed me. And you'll learn a whole lot more than I can tell you right now. But what I think about now, and I've been asked this a lot, is I think about all 18, 19, and 20-year-old guys that were killed, guys that didn't even have a date in their life, much less get married. And they gave their lives for freedom, for all. In fact, that's my website, www.letfreedomringforall.
A round of applause for him, please, because that's very important, very telling.
George, so please let everyone know where they can purchase your book and all the different websites that you have. They can follow up on your story.
Okay, the book, you have to purchase it from me. Well, you can get it from Amazon, but I make more money if I sell it.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
You know, when I turned 81, I became a filmmaker doing documentaries. I did 6 documentaries over 13 years. This one I won first prize in Palm Springs at the Documentary Film Festival.
Congratulations on it. A round of applause for George, please.
You see that? That's me when I was 20 years old holding a little 3-year-old German girl. And
wow.
And see the Jeep down below? The kids in my Jeep? I say my Jeep. You know what? I borrowed this Jeep. And I damn near got court-martialed.
Let the audience know, briefly, your last trip to Normandy, when was it?
My last trip to Normandy was during this film. I took other D-Day veterans, American Airlines flew us there. It was in 2019.
Right. 2019.
Yeah.
How about that, folks?
Round of applause for George. George, thank you so much for coming on the show this evening and letting the audience get a little history lesson of what you went through for this nation, for this country, and everything that we stand for today. We appreciate your service and what you did for
very
it.
Good.
So thank you, George.
George, you are all a prize.
So, Tony, who are we going to come up with?
So, you know what, folks? Let's give a big round of applause for our next guest. He's a fantastic singer, entertainer, Frankie Mamone.
Sema mi palasen all the day. Che lo solo fonte troverai un sorriso per me, anche se c'è dentro forte per mai il silenzio tra di noi, penso ancora sai. Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, well, goodbye. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile. And maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through. If you just smile.
You can smile to somebody sitting right next to you. You can uplift them
it doesn't cost a thing. That means so much. Anche se c'è dentro porte per mai, il silenzio tra di noi, penso ancora sai, once upon a time, a girl with moonlight in her eyes put her hand in mine and said she loved me so. But that was once upon a time, very long ago. Once upon a hill, we sat beneath the willow tree, counting all the stars and waiting for the dawn. But that was once upon a time. Now the tree is gone. How the breeze ruffled through his head. How we always laughed as though tomorrow wasn't there. We were young and didn't have a care. Once upon a time, the world was sweeter than we knew. Everything was ours, how happy we were then. But somehow, once upon a time, never comes again. How the breeze ruffled through her hair. How we always laughed as though tomorrow wasn't there. We were young and didn't have a care. Where did it go? Once upon a time, the world was sweeter than we knew. Everything was ours, how happy we were then. But somehow, once upon a time, never comes again.
Wow, Frankie, that was a terrific song, man. You're awesome.
Thank you. I enjoyed that one.
Let the audience know. Give a little feedback of what got you out here in the valley and what you've been doing.
Well, I've started music when I was a child. My parents were very influential with that. My dad had a voice like Mario Lanza. My mom was a great entertainer and a teacher. And we worked all over the Los Angeles area. And I've sang in Italy, quite a bit in Italy. And I love music. That's one of the great things. And it's in my blood, and I love romantic songs.
Well, you're a fantastic entertainer. And it's by the song that you sang. And like I said, I hope you sing some more for us this evening. I appreciate it.
I sure will. Thank you.
So that may lead into my question here is, why the music of Tony Bennett? I noticed that you sing a lot of Tony Bennett.
Tony Bennett is a legend. He's Tony Bennett. 70 years of being a top performer that no other
no other entertainer could ever duplicate what a career he's had. And he picked only the very best songs. And he was a humanitarian, he was Italian, I'm Italian, we feel the same passion for music.
And he has a fantastic voice, so if you had to pattern yourself in that manner, he's the perfect person. As a matter of fact, I even think Frank Sinatra at some point in his career said that Tony Bennett is the pinnacle as far as singing. Am I correct in that
assumption? You're absolutely right, yes. I also do a Jerry Vale tribute.
And I saw Jerry Vale as a kid, and I gotta tell you, I know growing up being Italian, as we all are here, I had the luxury of seeing him, so please, tell us, yeah.
Well, his wife, Rita, she's the one authorized me, she's the only tributor for my husband, and nobody else better try to do his music but you. She says, do it every week, change up the music, you have my permission to do it. She says, you represent my husband very well. We used to have the Italian bakery and we had a supper club, and Jerry loved our cannolis. He was crazy about our cannolis.
Oh man, my weakness, so krypton.
We became friends with Rita and Jerry, and great people to know.
Tell us a little bit about that. I understand, you know, I've tasted your pastries, and you're quite the baker.
Yes, I have a passion for music.
How about that?
Passion for music, for food, for the romance of living. That's being Italian, isn't it?
I was going to say, what's an Italian all about? Good food and good music, right?
Absolutely. With passion.
And the wine. Go ahead, by the way.
Absolutely.
So what are you doing these days?
I'm just doing singing. I'm doing the tribute shows. I've got several different shows lined up. The next one's December 3rd. It's a matinee at the Neurovitality Center, and that's Tony Bennett, and I'm so blessed to have Chris Bennett. Grammy nominated, she's my Lady Gaga, and she's my dear friend.
That's awesome, wonderful.
Fantastic.
So, and any other opportunities for the folks to know where they can catch your show?
I have several country clubs lined up, and I'll be putting it on my website. Frankie's Italian Bakery.
That's a perfect.
How about that? How original. Okay.
That's when you cut me off. No, keep talking.
It's all right. It's Frankie's show. So, Frankie, are you going to sing for us?
Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frankie Minogue.
I want to be around to pick up the pieces when somebody breaks your heart. Somebody twice as smart as I. A somebody who would swear to be true as you used to do with me. That leaves you to learn that misery loves company. Wait and see. I said I want to be around to see how he does it when he breaks your heart in two
bits.
Let's see if the trouble fits so fine. And that's when I'll discover that revenge is sweet, as I sit there applauding from a front row seat. When somebody breaks your heart like you broke mine. Chris Bennett. Somebody breaks your heart as mine, and that's when I'll discover that revenge is sweet, as I sit there applauding from a front row seat. When somebody breaks your heart like you broke mine.
Kimball's unique boutique, located in beautiful downtown Palm Springs, is for women who are not afraid to attract attention. Our clothing is feminine, flirty, fun, and fabulous. Get the latest look.
large selection of jewelry, hats, and much more. Personalized service inspires our customers to keep coming back. Kimball's Boutique, across from the Hyde in beautiful Palm Springs. We look forward to having you shop with us, and don't forget to mention the Mark and Tony Show for your 20% discount on your purchase.
Hi, I'm Mark Lancero.
And I'm Tony Pomponio.
We're here to tell you, if you missed the show on Thursdays, no worries.
You can catch a show and all of our previous shows on YouTube 24/7.
Just go to the YouTube search bar and type in The Mark and Tony Show.
The Mark and Tony Show! Be there!
That's Joey DeFonso, a.k.a. Mark Murphy.
I'm no snitch, but I really don't like the way he treats women.
What do you think you're doing?
He got in some trouble with the boys back in Chicago a few months back. So the FBI bought him and his family a one-way ticket to Palm Springs, California.
I got this idea. I want to run for mayor.
On the condition that he keeps his nose clean and his mouth shut.
I don't think this is a good idea.
Yeah, like that's gonna happen.
Filmed on location in Palm Springs.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Mark and Tony Show, along with our MC, Miss Laura Hagen, playing the female version of Rod Stewart.
Oh, yes.
If
you're, and if you're wondering, well, Laura, why don't you tell let the audience know what's going on here with everybody up front.
Okay, let everybody we've got lovely ladies up here that are dressed in costume for Halloween this year, and we're going to do a little contest, and oh my goodness, it's going to be a tough contest, I can tell.
First, second, and a third prize in honor of Oscars here. They're doing this, so I wanted to make sure we plugged Oscars.
Yes.
They're very cordial and very nice to give the winner, second, and third place person a nice gift certificate.
Oscars is amazing.
They've been very good to us. So everybody, a round of applause, please. Thank you.
Yeah. So third place is
Black Widow. You're welcome. You're welcome. Second place. All right, Kristen, right here. Second place.
There you go. We'll have two second places.
All right. And the first place, drum roll, please, Tony. And the first place goes to
Armana.
First place, right here.
There it is, Armana.
Okay,
that was a lot of fun, guys. Thank you so much for participating. We appreciate it.
You're all beautiful.
Thank you, everybody, for coming to the Mark and Tony Show. We appreciate your Halloween costumes and everything.
You know what? I'll tell you. I'll say this, and I'm blue in the face. George Ciampa, what a story. Come on, folks. Give him a hand. George Ciampa, thank you so much.
Again, a World War II vet. Laura, who was our other guest on the show?
Oh, Frankie Mamone.
Yeah, how about a round of applause for Frankie?
A round for Frankie.
And beautiful Chris Bennett.
There they are. Very nice. Gosh.
Terrific.
The dynamic duel. There they are. Well, so everybody, we want to thank you. So what do we always do? Laura, you ready for this? Tony and always do it. Do it, Tony.
We'll see you next week.